Hi everyone, Kristen here on behalf of Virtual Clarinet Academy. Today I'm going to share with you some really easy ways you can make sure that your clarinet stays healthy during cold and flu season. First and foremost, make sure that you're taking care of yourself, washing your hands, drinking enough water, following the guidelines of doctors or other medical professionals. It's really easy to spread germs, so do everything you can to make sure you're healthy first and foremost. Next, take a moment to clean anything that has touched your mouth. For sure, you must clean your mouthpiece. Take off that old mouthpiece patch, put on a new one once it's clean. Look over your reeds. Definitely throw away anything you might have played on while you were not feeling well. But otherwise, just kind of give them a once over and get rid of any that are old, chipped, warped, that you're not using anymore anyway. A very easy thing you can do is make sure that your swab is clean. So either throw it in with a load of clothes or hand wash it with some gentle detergent or kitchen soap. Either way, rinse thoroughly and let that swab air dry. Don't throw it in the dryer. A lot of swabs are silk and it will ruin it. Take a few minutes to use a cotton swab or a Q-tip to scrape inside all of your tone holes to get rid of any extra skin or other goo that might be in there. Just again, eliminate anything that might be extra on your clarinet that could be carrying germs or just really doesn't need to be there. Don't forget to clean your case as well. Take a moment to get rid of any reed wrappers or sleeves that might be just kind of existing in your case. Use a disinfectant to wipe down the handle, the clasps, any other part of your case that you touch pretty regularly. And then also take a vacuum and just get the inside of there with one of the attachments. Last but not least, a gentle reminder that you should never, ever, under any circumstances, put your clarinet underwater, put it in a bath, get it wet in any way. This is going to ruin your instrument. Same goes for the keys. Unless you're an experienced professional who has done special cleaning on the keys, don't do any DIY projects. This is not a great option and could end up being very expensive in the long run. Thanks so much for watching. Share this with a friend if you found it helpful. And otherwise, stay healthy and happy practicing.